So you ready to take your bass boat out on big water? Years of experience at Big Bass Water, Great Lakes, Lake Champlain, Potomac River, and across the country, I've got the proper equipment for my boat to be ready on Big Bass Water. But let me start off with the most basic, and that's to check on your bilge pumps. Coast Guard, very humble, I'm going to say, the Canadian Coast Guard had to save me one time on Lake Erie, and it all came down to a bilge pump that wasn't working. Second thing I want to point out is their trolling motor. I don't think there's a piece of equipment more commonly that breaks off in big ways than a trolling motor. And there's two components to it that I really want to emphasize, or two products I really want to emphasize on your trolling motor. A couple years back, I spent 45 minutes in 3-foot waves putting my trolling motor back together. I say my motor, it's really just a mount, but I sheared off some bolts. Mistake number one I'd made is that I only had 4 bolts, and your trolling motor mount can hold 6. You should always put all 6 bolts in with locking nuts underneath. Second thing I would emphasize on trolling motors is to make sure you have multiple straps. And number 3, I said 2, but I meant 3, TH Marine Troll Tamer. Will hold that trolling motor in place even when you're running up and down the roads, across the lakes, to minimize the vibration. I would say the second most commonly piece of equipment to get broke off in big waves are fish finders up front. See, I've got a dual mount here with dual grabs. These things are heavy. And something that fishermen often forget is how heavy these are, and the vibration and the violent vibrations you're going over waves. Get a trustworthy graph. I have mine from Straight Up Mounts. You can see in the video, link of that will show up in just a moment, when I installed this sucker, is that you can actually stand on it. That mount is one of the cheapest on the market. On top of being extremely tough, it's also one of the cheapest on the market. Look down below, got a promo code on those to save you a few more bucks too. And they are made in America. Well, say caring for your batteries is ultra important too. There is a thing called catastrophic battery failure, and that is almost always the result of a battery taking too much of a beating, vibrating, bouncing up and down, which can happen on the water, can also happen on the road. But if you ever had batteries that for one reason or another, you can't explain it, just failed on you, it's a good chance it took too big of a beating. I have, underneath all my batteries, a battery guard made by Megaware. Very cheap investment that minimizes the vibration and the bounce of batteries in rough water. Want to make sure your battery trays are in good shape. Battery trays will break while you're running through rough water. So when I go out of town, I make sure I have a couple extra battery trays so I can replace those. But ever since I got those battery guards, I have never had a problem with battery failure. Doesn't do any good to get to your fishing spot to have your fishing equipment damaged, especially your rods and reels. Very important you got them strapped down here. Keep them in place. You can see I'm actually using my trolling motor cables as well to hold those in place. But you should also consider the rods that you have underneath in your locker that can be bounced. If they're not strapped down, bouncing up and down and damaging those, having a big bird's nest, big tangles underneath. So make sure your rods underneath are secure. If you can, get an extra rod strap like this and install it inside your rod locker. Something else I would emphasize with your rods and storage underneath is to make sure they are covered up with a reliable rod cover. Because again, you're going to be bouncing around and avoid tangles. I would put a good rod cover on every single rod underneath. Perhaps the most important piece of advice you can get is to tighten every bolt you can find. Every single one of them. Yeah, every year you see on the Great Lakes people getting to shore, having their boats at boat ramps and their outboard motors just barely hanging on because they failed to tighten jack plate screws throughout the course of the season. Yeah, they can vibrate loose and fall off. That's talk about catastrophic ruining your days. You may not be aware that your boat is actually 2 pieces of fiberglass and they're being held together right here at the rub rail. And the screws underneath that rub rail will often vibrate and come out. So yes, take off the rub rail and check the screws underneath the rub rail to make sure those are together. Otherwise, you could theoretically absolutely have your boat split in two. One more thing I would say about a graph, about your fish finders, are to have extra gimbal mounts. If you're going to run across a lake with these attached, have an extra gimbal mount. If you're going on a long trip, because those can fracture and break. And once that happens, you're going to be out of action. Thank you for tuning in. Hopefully this will help you keep safe out on those big bodies of water. Have fun having a blast with smallmouth bass.